following year, the smith Culann invited Conor to a banquet and asked him to bring only a few of his companions, as he had neither the space nor the means for a grand entertainment. Conor accepted, and before he set out, he went to his custom to see and say farewell to the boys at the corpse. He watched them at four games. In the first, Satanta kept goal against all the 350s, and they could not score. Yet, when they all kept a goal together, he scored against them as he wished. When they all guarded together, he had no difficulty in getting the ball past them in the hole. The third game was the tearing off of mantles. Satanta tore all the 150 mantles off in a trace. They could not as such as touch his crotch. In the fourth game, they wrestled. With all the corpse against him, Satanta stood firm on his feet, yet when he turned to attack, he left not one standing.
That lad's deeds, when he is full grown, are in keeping with his deeds today. We are lucky land to have him.
Is there no reason to believe that his prowess, alone of all, will increase with the years?
Let him come with us to Culann's feast. He is worthy.
I cannot go just yet.
Why so?
Because the boys are not finished playing, and I cannot leave until the games are finished.
We cannot wait so long.
You need not wait. I shall follow you.
You do not know the way.
I shall follow the tracks of your chariot.
That was agreed, and Connor's party arrived at Culann's house, where they were welcomed to the feast which was already laid for them.
Before we begin, tell me, is there any more to come, or is this all?
None. All are here.
Because I have a hound dog who guards my home. She listens to none in the land except me.
You may loose the hound.
Meanwhile, the six-year-old boy had left his fellows to the boy corpse of Emma Merchen and was on his way to the house of Culann the smith. He had no arms of defense but passed the time of his journey with his hurling stick and ball. The hound barked a fearsome challenge as he came to the house, but the boy continued his play until the hound sprang at him. He hurled the ball, he gasped its hind legs, and smashed its head to a pulp on the stones of the yard. With terrific force, at the sound of the hound's baying, Conor had leapt to his feet, remembering the boy. They all rushed out, certain Satanta was being torn by the hound. And were overjoyed to see him alive. all except Culann, who was filled with sorrow as he gazed on the hound.
"'Tis was an unlucky day. I made a banquet for Connor. You are welcome, boy, for your father and mother's sake, but not of your own. You have slain my guard dog and protector of my house and substance and my flocks and herds."
"Do not grieve. I shall see that you are none the worse for what has happened."
"How can this be?"
"If there is a whelp of that dog siring in all Ireland, I shall rear and train it until it is able to guard and protect you as well as its sire. And until then, I myself will guard your house and your property, even as your hound did."
"That is fair."
"And you will be Culann, the Hound of Culann, in the meantime. And that shall be your name, Culann."
"Indeed, I prefer my own name, Satanta, son of Sualtam."
"But the name Culann will be on the lips of the men of Ireland and the world, and their mouths will be full of its praise."
"For that, I would accept my name."
"The lad's deeds when he is full grown are in keeping. With his deeds today, we are lucky land to have him."
"Is there any reason to believe that his prowess alone..." I forgot the line.
"I can't see that far."
Okay.
"If that lad leads..." "Why cannot wait so long? A what?"